Let's see how the market is doing at the SGX Nifty level. 29-30 points higher is what you have. Perhaps does not change too many things, but let's see from here where we go. Ashwini Gujral, Sudarshan Sukhani and Mithesh Thakkar now join us. Good morning. Ashwini, your thoughts first. You were advising short yesterday. You think that is still the bigger trade to short the rally now?
Well, good morning. And the caveat there was that we should have follow through in global markets. Now, with the patchy kind of follow through, I think the better trade is 10,800, which is a 50-day moving average. If for some reason we get there, maybe you should try a long trade, because if you have no follow through and shorts don't get immediate downside, then the market can again become choppy and move in that 10,800, 11,000 band. But I don't think the same amount of bullishness is now warranted which we had for last many days. And no great trend, just choppiness, 10,800 to about 10,950 still holds on for the moment.
Let me get to Sudarshan on the same issue. Good morning, Sudarshan. What's your sense? Break down, break out, or stay the range?
Hi, good morning. Down and out, absolutely. The market was finding support at 10,850. And that's why we said, let us be bullish, because the market is in an uptrend. It has to prove that it's not going up. Unfortunately, yesterday it proved that it could go down very easily, break that level and actually close lower. The closing even then was not important. The very fact that 10,850 was breached on the downside was a signal to exit long positions. So as of date, there are no positions. Now the Nifty is again trying to go up, which doesn't give a sense of where it wants to go. It does at least tell me that after that long protracted trading range, the fact that the range broke on the downside is a warning that even if we have an up move, it's not going to be another bull leg. It'll just be some noise. So today there is no trade, but the trade now may be coming on the short side. Yes.
Okay. Sorry, what is the falsification of this theory? When will you say, no, this is a wrong diagnosis? I'm asking you because crude is lower. Now, of course, it can be argued on both sides, crude being lower. There's also a growth scare. As well, Piyush Goyal will be seen as a bullish factor. So I'm asking you, at what point will you say, this trade is not working, this short trade?
That's a fair question. At this point, there is no trade. If the Nifty crosses 10,950 and closes above it, then it's saying again that perhaps yesterday was an aberration and again we are going up. Perhaps that will become a short-term buy signal. But as of now, there is no trade. Wait for either 950 to be crossed or just wait.
Okay, well, trading the index is no mean task, I think. Getting more and more frustrating. But Mithesh, let us get your thoughts in as well on the boundaries. What are you doing? What's the call on either the Nifty or the Bank Nifty?
Yeah, so I think, multiple failures around the 10,950-970 mark do not bode well, but I still haven't seen a breakdown. So I think it's still a range, broadly 10,700-670 on the downside, about 10,950-980 on the upside. But I think, slowly the indicator position is on the medium-term charts is deteriorating. So there is now slightly more risk of a downside breakdown. But we'll cover that point when we reach it. For the timing, I think I maintain that 10,750-730-700, broadly the 50-point range should be a good support. And unless that is being broken, you will keep oscillating between this range. Though yesterday's breakdown means that we could possibly now head towards the lower range first before we again try to attempt a recovery from there.
Fair point. Okay, with that, let's get to the individual stock picks. Ashwini, what are you buying or selling?
See, basically, in a choppy market, you have to go on both sides. So Sun TV and in general media space looks like it's made some sort of a bottom, so that's a buy with a stop of 525, target of 540. United Spirits is a sell with a stop of 585, target of 560. BHEL is a sell with a stop of 71, target of 64. Petronet is a buy with a stop of 220, target of 236. And Bata is a buy with a stop of 1145, target of 1180.
Okay, fair enough. Sudarshan, good morning. What's on your list today? Buy and sell?
Well, it's buy and sells, and that reflects the confusion also in my mind. It's almost the same. Tech Mahindra and Nestle are buying opportunities. These were two stocks among the very few that actually closed higher yesterday. And they have attractive chart patterns. So in a choppy market, if something can go up, these are two stocks that could go up. I have a lot of sells then. Motherson Sumi, which is a short sell. Small rallies in Motherson Sumi are failing repeatedly. Tata Motors, where again the same story, you know, big stories come up. There is a 5 to 10 rupee rally and then it comes down. I continue to believe that Tata Motors will eventually go into double digits. And NTPC, where a similar rally has fizzled out. It's a difficult day to trade.
Okay, but I before I hand it over to Mithesh, Idea, Sudarshan, in fact, Idea and Bharti, but certainly Idea, I mean, this is a huge amount of money. It's like over $3 billion that's getting pumped into that stock, into that company. Which way is the chart headed?
No, for Idea, the chart is headed down. I don't think there's anything in it. Bharti is trying to find stability. Bharti Airtel at some point will become a buying opportunity.
Okay, all right. Mithesh, let's go through your list as well. And I don't think anyone's mentioned Indigo today. In case you have any thoughts along with the list, maybe a word on Interglobe as well, if there's a trade at all.
Yeah, so I think, you know, Indigo, broadly, if you see, it's tried to find some base around 1050 mark, but on the upside, failing to get past the 1140 level. So I think this range of 1140, 1050 will continue. As of now, no directional bias over there. But coming to my stock picks, I have, after a long time, more sell ideas than buy ideas. The buy is on Tech Mahindra. I think Sudarshan also mentioned the stock, very positive setup of indicators there. So buy with the stop at 713 half, look for a 737, 740 kind of a first target. And on the sell side, I have Grasim, which is a sell with a stop at 801 for targets of 755. A BHEL, which can be sold with a very tight stop at 70 half, look for declines to about levels of 66. And GSFC, the indicator setup is turning negative, so sell with a stop at 109 for targets of 100.
Okay. Gentlemen, do stay on. We will have lots of more questions for you stock-wise. Let's give you a glimpse of what happened at Davos yesterday. Shireen caught up with a man who is lately not seen too much on TV, Anand Mahindra, chairman of the Mahindra Group. And he says they are not looking to... Well, for the stock market, the big news that he said was they're not spinning off the tractor business anytime now.
These kinds of questions are not new. They're not something that we look at in stealth. They're questions about value and about business strategy. And is there a value and merit in auto
is
and
there?
Farm? We're still together, which
no,
means...
No, in terms of splitting it up.
No, is there? We are finding continued value in being together. If you look at anybody, I was just in another interview just now where people were asking about scale. You know that every auto business, every mobility business in the world is looking at scale. We have scale because if you look at the auto and farm businesses, the things they share at the back end or the things they share in human resources, in procurement, in R&D, in co-location, those kinds of synergies you don't give up easily. Mm. Other people are scrounging to find them. So yes, there could be a bit of a pop if you say, I'm going to separate this in order to get a higher PE. We're players for the long term. We're not here to please the markets for a very short-term pop-up if we see value in long-term synergy.
So it's not something that you're considering? You don't believe it makes sense?
We consider everything all the time. We are such a large group, at every point in time we'll have somebody saying, why don't you do this?
But you don't believe it merits discussion or taking forward at this point?
Not so far, no.